Hallelujah. Welcome everyone to All for Jesus Church. Hallelujah. We are now on our Sunday worship. We're going to worship the Lord. Hallelujah. Welcome, sister. Praise God. Let's sing the first song, More of You. Let's worship Him. Jesus Church, Pastor Efren Landaos. Praise the Lord.
It's time to fellowship with the Lord. This is a happy day. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. For apart from Him, we cannot do anything. He holds our life. He holds our blessing. He holds everything in us. Amen? Hallelujah. That's why it's very important. God is so good to us. Amen? Amen. And our effort to fellowship with the Lord is not in vain. Because not only financial, He supported us, but also long and satisfied life in this world. And in the end, well, it says in Ecclesiastes 3:2, time to be born and time to die. Even if you are 200 years old, like Matusalem or Methuselah. Methuselah is the oldest people who live in this world, 965 years old. But during that time, there is no people yet. They are still growing in population. Amen? Amen? Hallelujah. And our Bible study for today is the command of God, the command of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Why? Because in John 10:30, Jesus said, I and the Father are one. Amen. And in John 10:38, He said, the Father is in me, and I am in the Father. And in John, John 49, in John 49, the Father, I am in the Father, those who have seen me have seen the Father. Wow, a great testimony. The proof that Jesus and the Father and the Holy Spirit are one. Amen? Hallelujah. And we go to the command of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ in Matthew 28, verse 16 to 20. Amen. Hallelujah. This is after the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ. Before ascending to heaven, he met all his disciples and gave the command. This is what God said, the Great Commission. Amen. Hallelujah. In verse 16, I read, now the 11 disciples went to Galilee, to the mountain to which Jesus has directed them. When they saw him, they worshiped him, but some doubted. They still cannot believe that Jesus Christ lives. After 3 days, he resurrected. Amen. And in verse 18, this is the command. And Jesus came and said to them, all authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. After the saving works of Jesus Christ, he said, all the authority, meaning still God is with him. He cannot be separated with God, for they are one. But God, the Father, gave the authority, God the Son, everything, all the authority in heaven and earth has been given to me, and the command is, go. We don't need only to be a follower, a listener of Jesus Christ, of the Word of God. After that, we need to serve the Lord. We need to share the Word of God boldly, nothing to be ashamed. We don't need to be ashamed of the name of Jesus, because the name is our salvation. Amen? We will live forever. There is life after this. This is temporary place to live in. We are just passing by. We will all die generation to generation. And the coming of Jesus Christ is very soon. Revelation 22:20. You never know. Maybe while we are fellowshipping, maybe after this, maybe next week, next month, you never know. But it's good to be prepared. Amen. That we pray for our loved ones. That is the most important thing. Lord, use me for my husband. Use me for my children, my nieces, my nephews, all that I love. Use me, O Lord. I don't want them to be left behind. In your coming, I want everybody, all of us, should be in Jesus Christ, in heaven, the permanent place where there is mansion prepared for all of us. Amen. Oh, hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Glory to God. Go therefore and make disciples. This is the command of God. What shall we do after making disciples, bringing people to Christ, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
One God in three persons, Almighty God. Listen carefully, brothers and sisters, here and worldwide. If your God is not the creator of heaven and earth and all it contains, that is false God. If your God is human being who was born in this world, that is false God. If it is animals or anything in this world that you see, that is false God. The true salvation is in true God, through the Father, in the name of His Son, Jesus Christ. That is the true God. That's why we don't need to hate the people. We need to have pity on them. We need to share the truth, the word of God, even worldwide. That is the command of the Lord. Go to all nations. That's why we had a video, we had a camera. That's why we don't need to go there. At one, just as one click of your computer or cell phone, you will watch the gospel of your salvation. And in the end of this Bible study, you are ready because you know the truth that salvation is only through Jesus Christ. And you will receive Him, and you and your family will be saved. That is the promise of God. Acts 16:31. Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, you will be saved, you and your household. All package deal. Why? Because God will use you for your family. Yes. You are not ashamed, you are not afraid to tell them that we need to be saved. There is permanent life after this world. Hallelujah. Praise His holy name. Thank you, Jesus. And in verse 20, teaching them to obey everything that I have commanded you. And this is the promise of God. Remember, I am with you always to the end of the age. God will not leave us nor forsake us, even our loved ones. If you are faithful to God, if you love the Lord, there is protection. In times of trouble, God was there. Amen. To guide you, to lead you, to save you.
Amen.
Oh, hallelujah, what a promise of God. And the most promises of God in Psalm 91, verse 14 to 16 is, I will give you, because you love me, I will give you long life. Long and satisfied life. And in the end of this age, eternal life in my kingdom.
Amen.
Ooh, hallelujah. A short Bible study, but it stick in our hearts. Because this is about our life. Our blessing while we are living on earth. Our long and satisfied life, even if you get sick, that is normal, but God will heal you because Jesus Christ is the great healer.
Yes.
To satisfy you with long life, God will never, doesn't want you to die. Whatever happens, you will live. I shall not die but live to declare the works of the Lord. Oh, hallelujah, praise the holy name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. So, the big question is, where are we now? Because this is not yet the time, we are not perfect yet, we are in sin. Daily, knowingly and unknowingly, we sin against God. But the good thing is, we have Jesus Christ, who will forgive our sin. Amen. Hallelujah. So how, where are we now? We are all sinners. Romans 3:23. For all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. We cannot boast that, oh, I know Jesus Christ, I know the whole Bible. No, you cannot boast about anything. To humble yourself, make everybody greater than you. Don't think that you are greater than other people. Humble yourself. That's what Jesus Christ shows us when He came to save us. Amen? Amen. Supposed to be when He came to this world, she would be in a great mansion or big places, a beautiful places. But no, He was born in a manger to humble, to show us humility. That we need to humble ourselves, because if we humble ourselves, God will lift us up. If you are boastful about yourself, about anything you possess, your possession, your profession, your riches, if you boast about that, God will put you down. It's very, very clear. Amen? That's why salvation is a package deal to the Lord. If you love the Lord, if you are faithful to God, it says in Matthew 10:22, you will be hated by many, but those who endure to the end shall be saved. So salvation is only through Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. So how did we get in sin? Because of disobedience. The disobedience of one man, Adam, it was passed through all generation. And because of the righteousness of one man, Jesus Christ, who came to this world to save the lost, we all have righteousness. We are not righteous, but we all have righteousness. Christ Jesus, our righteousness to God. Amen? Amen. Hallelujah. So, Romans 5:19, Adam sinned, but Jesus saved us. Hallelujah. Where do we want to go now, knowing that we are sinners? We want to reconcile to God. We need to return to God, everybody here, and those who are watching worldwide. We need Jesus more than ever. We need to return to God. And the only way in John 14:6 is Jesus Christ. Jesus said, I am the only way to the Father. I am the only truth about the Father. And I am the light that comes from the Father. So you will live forever if you believe in me and my works and my Father. Amen. Hallelujah. So it says here we need to reconcile. This is a message not only for believers, but also to unbelievers. Know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. If the Son of God set you free, you are free indeed. Wow, what a promises of God. And to reconcile to God is through Jesus Christ in Colossians 1:20. Amen. And how we reconcile to God? God did the first move. John 3:16. For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in Him, believe, should not perish but have an everlasting life. God did the first move. What is our part? Acts 16:31. Just believe in the Lord Jesus Christ. You will be saved, you and your household. God did the first move, and the second move is for all of us. We need to believe. Amen. And this is the part that is very, very good for all of us. Because we are still on earth, we are living, we need the blessing, we need everything in this world. But we need to use that for the Lord. It says here in John 15:7, Jesus said, if you abide in me and my words abides in you, ask whatever you will and it shall be done unto you.
Amen.
Wow, very, very clear. Amen. So that is the four questions that we answer by the truth, by the word of God. Amen.
Amen.
So finally, as we understand the truth, as we are ready, or we receive Jesus already, and for those unbelievers who are listening, it's time for you. Tomorrow is not a promise. Now you are living, tomorrow you never know. tomorrow is not a promise. Amen. We are now the soldier of Christ. When you receive Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, you are now going to serve the Lord. We are the soldier of Christ, and we are commanded to make disciples to all nations. You don't need to go to Japan. How about COVID-19? You don't need to go to Korea. That camera, that video, just one click, we will meet each other and you would listen to the truth of your salvation. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. And when they believe the truth, automatically baptize them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The same thing we should do with our family. If they are ready, if they know the truth, if they read the Bible, and they want to be saved, Paul, parents want all her loved ones to be together. You need to tell them to receive Jesus